Oh my God. San Bernardino City. Okay, and Kennedy Jones. At the fucking Insomniac event. It's massive. What do they call that shit?
Go, Mom. We gotta go rave, Mom.
This new tune, you're gonna shit your pants.
This,
only the finest,
is the product of an Instagram picture taken by some girl that my roommate knows, and then my mom managed to get a hold of the logo, now with 20% more fat. Should I wear this for the show?
That'd be funny.
Kenneth Cole reaction, too. With the extended big pouch for a Kenneth Cole type man.
Why do you have sunglasses on?
I got sunglasses on because I came from the club yesterday, straight to the plane, got 3 hours of sleep, and now I'm here.
Come here, baby. Tell them about it. Playing together?
Yeah, we've done it before many times, and our chemistry is
amazing.
And you wouldn't think that we were two separate artists.
But I'm a little bit nervous just for the simple fact of, you know, just for the sake of, like, it's our first Insomniac event, and we get to share it and do it together, and it's, you know, it's cool.
It gets to show how hard we really pushed ourselves this year.
Right.
Like, this has only been happening since February, and like since the end of the year, like from that point from February to now, that we get to play festivals is
a godsend.
Yeah,
it's great.
Blessing.
Like last year at Escape, you know, Asaf was standing next to me right before he went on, and he's like, turns to me and he's like, "This is you next year. Like, you're playing this next year." Like, and I was like, "Yeah, right, bro." Like, even like up until right now, while we're talking, you know, and even the whole way here today and the whole flight here, still isn't really real to me that like I'm doing this, because I've looked at these events in such a way for so long, and like now I'm here and like about to play, still not real to me. I don't think it's gonna be real until we actually get up there and like play our first tune and we get a reaction, and it's just, you know, it's gonna be fun, man. It's so blessing, you know, like, I can't wait. Fresh to share with this guy. Yeah. Crazy, because like, yeah, it was that real shit. It was that real festival.
I had to keep myself from looking at the crowd. I turned around and was like,
yeah, it was a lot going on.
And then you try not to look away from this huge ass stage, so it was like everywhere you looked, you're fucked.
Yeah, but it was definitely makes you see what you do in a completely different light playing something.
This is what it's all for.
Yeah.
That's what it's for.
And we played relatively known older songs of ours that were not brand new, and like we play a lot of unreleased stuff, but for the most part we played a lot of our own music, our own compositions that were like known, but they're old, you know, they were like throwback to us, but to some of those people they're brand new, and to a lot of those people that's their current song that they like, you know. So it was cool, man. And you and I, like, I gotta give it to you, dude. Like, I wouldn't have rather been up here with anybody else
except yes.
No, even Tiesto, I wouldn't have vibed with like that.
Come back, never release me. Fox, too.
I'm a red fox.
They're not a magic really? Fox, but he's got a red
I'm
hair.
I'm a gangbanger
like
fox, is he?
Gangbanger fox?
Where is he?
Over here.
Show him, show the camera. Show him what we did.
Does anybody have
oh! Rip it off, Mo.
Oh, really? Wax your back.
Oh!
That really fucked up.
Yo, you can sell that now.
Ew. That's on eBay.
Like a wrecking ball!
That's just great.
400, thank you, bass god.
Sometimes as an artist, you want to develop your own integrity and your own individualism, and you want to feel, like, accountable for some success, but, like, it's really important to me and him. He knows too, just as well. It's just as important for both of us to remember that, like, we don't forget who helped us. You know, we don't forget why we're here. You know, we have a part in it. We make the music, but we don't forget why and how we got here. And, like, honestly, you could be here today and not here tomorrow. And I don't mean life and death. I mean you play this festival today and tomorrow just fall off, and, like, it could be gone in a minute. So I feel like you gotta just appreciate it and appreciate where you come from, you know, in order to keep.
I've already performed at Insomniac, and I chill.
Is this an intervention?
No.
One rave, that's it, I'm done.